A worried Santa, trying hard to figure out a plan to fulfill his yearly target. Well, does he succeed? We will surely get to know at the end of this small play.
Ah, how do I complete my year-end target of making billions and billions of children happy this year? COVID, travel restrictions, and quarantine. Ah, I've also ended up reading memes that Christmas is delayed by 14 days due to COVID. Nobody can delay Jesus' birth. This year has only made all the kids sad and worried at home, and I do not want to be another reason adding on to it. I have to keep up my family's tradition of spreading cheer and happiness across the globe. Well, well, Lord Jesus has always helped me in all my woes. Remember last year, Rudolph had such a bad cold and a running nose on 23rd December, and I was worried as to who would ferry this tall, fat man with a fatter bag of gifts across, and my prayers just healed Rudolph. Let me pray to God again.
Santa kneels down with difficulty and prays to Lord Jesus. He opened the Bible and the first thing he could see was Matthew chapter 10 verse 1. Guessing what it is, let's read it together.
He called his 12 disciples to him and gave them authority to drive out evil spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. Well, well, if Jesus could send out his disciples out to heal the world, why can't I send a set of other Santas who can represent me? Thank you, Jesus. Ho, ho, ho.
Santa runs towards his piggy bank and starts counting the money left after buying all the gifts.
Ah, seems like I just have enough money to hire 7 professionals to share my job this year. Jesus had 12. Is this enough? Actually, I think one thing that we've all learned from MNCs is about cost cutting. 12 becomes 7. Thank you, MNCs.
Santa writes out a job description for his 7 associates. After a few days of wait, a zillion Zoom call interviews, and 14-day quarantine, we finally have all the 7 associates in one room with our Santa.
Good morning, dear associates. Ho, ho, ho. I'm very finally happy to meet you all physically.
Good morning, Mr. Santa. We are happy to meet you as well.
Thank you. Ho, ho, ho. I'm equally excited. The reason why you're all here is to make a billion kids happy around the year this year.
But how would we do that?
Relax, relax, my child. I've got you all covered. You have your training plan and your SOP well guarded in the sheet.
Okay, Santa.
Well, right before that, are you all aware of the significance of why I end up gifting children every year?
I know.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I know.
Well, well. Hold on. Let me probably take you guys back in time. Around 2000 years back, we had Jesus born to Virgin Mary and Joseph in a manger in Bethlehem. He had a humble birth and came down to save the world from its sin. And this is celebrated worldwide every year as Christmas, a festival of spreading joy and happiness. Therefore, my family started this tradition of gifting a small gift to all the good children across the globe.
But Santa, even I got the gifts from you when I was a kid. And if I'm not wrong, that Santa is always male character. So I've never seen female Santas around. So why do we have just 2 girls here?
Well, well, my dear children. Yes, Santa has always been a predominantly male character. However, it does not stop females from spreading happiness and joy in this world. Let me take you to another shorter trip down memory lane. When God created humans, God created Adam, a man, and later Eve, a female in his likeness. He created both as equals in this world. Over the course of time, I agree that males have dominated the world, but it does not mean that females have stayed behind. We have so many females that are much more successful and have managed multiple activities at a time. If the Pope can wash the legs of females at the Last Supper, why not I? And therefore, I deliberately got female associates to work on this job, and I'm sure they'll make me proud.
Thank you for trusting us, Santa.
Thank you, Santa. Thanks for helping us shed the male-dominant ego in us.
Yes, Santa. Thank you.
But Santa, can you explain how we should be carrying out this humongous activity? I mean, I'm so tiny and have tiny hands.
Definitely. To start off, never restrict your potential. All of us have great potential within us. It's been a family tradition that we start off with a small prayer. Let's start. Father God, give me all the strength to fulfill this desire of bringing a smile across many, many kids. Amen. To start off, all of you will be assigned a continent each, and you will have to spread across all the kids in that region.
What? An entire continent? No way. I get confused in the Chotu Gully Road of MS Palya. I always end up going on left while I should be on the right side.
Don't worry. God will help you. We've been doing it for centuries now. Taking back your memory line, when Joseph and Mary were searching for an inn in Bethlehem, there were so many places, but they did not find any space. At the end, they found a small stable and Jesus was born there. Likewise, God has a plan for everybody and you will succeed.
Okay, Santa, if you say so, but still, don't assign me Asia.
Ho ho ho, well, I think you will end up getting it. Good morning, dear associate. Hope you had all good sleep. Let's start off today's training. But wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where's the 7th associate?
I think they got scared and they ran away.
No. All of you were chosen with God's intercedence. I cannot afford missing out any of you. You know, Jesus tells a parable wherein a shepherd who had 100 sheep and lost one of them left the 99 at home and went searching for one lost sheep. I should search for one lost sheep.
Sorry, Santa, I'm late.
And look there, the 7th associate walks in. Oof, scared me, man. Taking this back to your training, none of you should run away stating that the address of any child was difficult and should leave the gift undelivered. Children expect Santa's gifts throughout the year and we should strive to make sure all of them get their gifts. Hope that is clear, associates, and I don't want to see any gift coming back to me.
Okay, Santa, but why are you rude to us?
Sorry, dear, I just got a little emotional over here. My apologies.
What? How can Santa be black?
No, this guy is scam. This guy is cheating us. Santa is always white as snow. This guy is fraud. Black people are bad.
My dear, please listen to me.
While walking, they notice a poor white beggar on the street.
Look, that white man walking there will help this beggar.
Hey, he was too busy and did not notice him. It's fine, another white man will help him. Let's wait.
Couple of white men and women walk by, but none of them help the beggar. Then comes a black man who not only helps the beggar with some money, but also lends his coat to the beggar. This followed by another white man giving some fruits to the beggar. This leads to a sense of question among the associates. The associates realize their mistake and go back and ask for forgiveness.
Welcome back, my dear kids. Racism is a very bad evil that is killing our society, and we all have to stand up to change it. Nobody should be judged on their outer appearance or color, but should be known by the good work they do. It is good that you have realized this on your own in such a small time. Make sure you do not discriminate against any kid due to their physical appearance, because we are all created in God's likeness.
This goes on for a couple more days, and at the end, Santa is finally happy with his new Santa family.
Finally, I'm happy to announce the first Santa graduation for 2020. If you think that was the end, then you're wrong. How can they even be Santas when they're not healthy?